Today we are going to talk about two different types of polyhedra, prism and pyramid. Let's start off with our prisms. Prisms are polyhedra. They have two parallel identical bases and their lateral faces are parallelograms. Typically they're rectangles, but they could be another type of parallelogram as well. If we take a look at the picture here, we see one base out front, and then in the back, there is another identical base. If the bases were to continue on, they would not run into each other as they are running parallel to each other. Then we look at our lateral faces, which are the sides of the figure, the faces that connect your bases. Our lateral faces here are rectangles. So that would make all of this a prism. I have a 3D example here. So looking at this figure, if I turn it, I can see that there are two bases. These bases are identical to each other. They are parallel. And then I can see that my lateral faces, my faces that connect my bases, are rectangles. So this is a prism. Then if we move over to pyramid, we see that a pyramid is also a polyhedra. It has one base compared to the prism, which has two bases. Our pyramid only has one. Opposite of that base is a vertex. That vertex connects all of our lateral faces together because all of our lateral faces are triangles, as we can see here. And all those triangles, that all the triangular lateral faces come to a vertex opposite of that base. Okay, so we've got prism and pyramid. They're similar but different. When you have two bases, then that is a prism. And when you have one, it is a pyramid. So let's take a look. There are many different kinds of prisms and pyramids. I have a small list here for you, and I'm going to show you a couple of 3D ones as well. Let's start with this one again, the same 3D shape of the picture here. As we can see, this is a prism because it's got two bases. Now we name our prisms and pyramids off of the shape of the base. So if I look at the base of this prism, I see that it is a triangle. Therefore, this figure here is a triangular prism. The bases are triangular and there are two bases. So that would make this a triangular prism. I've got another type of prism here. Again, I can see that I have two bases here. So then I take a look at that base. I see that it is a rectangle. So because it has two bases, it's a prism. Because it has rectangular bases, this would make this a rectangular prism. Now I want to point something out here. This is a rectangular prism. So technically, sometimes this might be my base. And then technically, I might turn it and maybe this is my base. This is my base. We can kind of, it sort of depends. Now the rectangular prism is the only figure that allows that. I cannot with my triangular prism say that this is the base. Okay, it's got to be my triangle. So this is a rectangular prism. Along that note, I want to take a look at this little guy right here. Again, we can see that this has two bases, so it would be a prism. If I look and see what shape my base is, I would say that this is a rectangular prism. However, this has a more specific name because it is a square, actually, and all faces are squares. This is called a cube, but a cube is a type of rectangular prism. It's just a little bit more specific. One more prism for you is this little guy. Again, I can see that there are two bases here and all of my lateral faces are rectangles. I can look at my base and to determine which kind of prism this is. This has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides on the base. Therefore, this would be a pentagonal prism. My base is a pentagon, so this is a pentagonal prism. All right, so let's look at some pyramids here. Again, this figure here is a 3D version of our picture. I can see that there is only one base, and opposite of that is the vertex where all the lateral faces meet. I go ahead and look also at the base to determine the name. This is a square, or more generally speaking, a rectangle that would make this a rectangular prism. Okay, sometimes it's called a square prism, or just a rectangular prism works as well. And then one more for today. I've got one more pyramid. This pyramid, again, has that base, and opposite of it, the lateral faces meet at that vertex. I look at my base to determine what kind of pyramid this is, and I see that it is three-sided, so that would make this a triangular pyramid, otherwise known as a tetrahedron. So again, I need to take a look at my bases and lateral faces, and that will help me determine between a pyramid and prism. And then the name, the shape of the base, will give me that second part to my polyhedron name.